my story began and ended in a hospital. From childhood, I was noted for my athletic and ambitious disposition. At just 7 years old, I could run faster than any other child my age. By the time high school started, I had tried and succeeded at every sport a girl could dream of. Every day after school, I would go from volleyball practice to lacrosse games to track meets. My ambitions set me apart from the rest of my classmates. I worked hard to be the fastest runner and the highest jumper.
Good. Keep up the good work. Those Penn State recruiters are coming to your big game next weekend.
Sure thing, coach.
In the fall of the 11th grade, I was named captain of the varsity volleyball squad. My boyfriend was the quarterback of the football team, and I received straight A's. 2 days later at the big game, the recruiters approached me and offered me a scholarship to play at Penn State. However, as perfect and wonderful as this may seem, nothing was ever good enough for me. My ambitious nature got the better of me, and I agreed to an offer that would determine my fate. Why? Why can't I do this? I need to be stronger. I'm so weak.
Hey there. I couldn't help but notice you benching all that weight. I have something you might want.
What are you gonna do? Sell me drugs or something?
Actually, yeah.
Hey, how much will it cost?
Shh, keep quiet and follow me.
How much?
$50.
Here.
I saw 7 needles, each separately wrapped and filled halfway with a dark brown liquid, and a handwritten set of directions.
Fingers crossed.
I continued to use a single dose of the steroids each week, and I heard the scream every time. The dreaded scream did not stop me from using the drugs. My confidence was boosted, my strength increased, and I played volleyball like no other girl has played before. A 6'4" hitter was no match for the opposing team's players. The Penn State recruiters still offered me the scholarship and were more and more impressed every time they came to watch me play. I now lay in my hospital bed trying to remember what had happened after the 7th dose. And I'm sure that when I wake up from the coma, my doctors will tell me and my parents will comfort me. I can feel an excruciating pain in my left arm, pain that I have never felt before, the pain of guilt. My heart beats faster and faster and faster.
This girl is